Coming up, I'll walk you through the new Microsoft Quantum Development Kit, now in preview. This is an important milestone that we've been working on to empower you in the quantum computing revolution. It forms a part of our differentiated approach to delivering a scalable end-to-end quantum system. The Quantum Development Kit makes it easy for you to start experimenting now. It includes a native quantum-focused programming language called Qsharp, local and Azure-hosted simulators for you to test your Qsharp solution, and sample Qsharp code and libraries to help you get started. In the next few minutes, I'll walk through a few code examples, and I'll explain where quantum principles like superposition and entanglement apply. If these concepts are new to you, then check out our previous episode to learn more. And you can download the code from our website to follow along. Let's get started. Here I'm in Visual Studio. I'd like to start with our version of Hello World in quantum computing, called teleportation, which is core to quantum algorithms and a great primer to begin your quantum computing journey. Teleportation enables communication between quantum bits on a single piece of quantum hardware, or even between remote quantum computers. It serves as a basis of a future quantum internet and shares many operations with quantum algorithms you will create and develop. In this program, I'll highlight the steps to initialize quantum resources, apply operations, and run your quantum algorithm. Let's look at the code. I've opened two project files for this demo. One, in our native quantum language, Qsharp, and the other, in a standard programming language, C#. This is because a quantum computer is like a coprocessor. It's much like how you program a GPU or FPGA, and then call the code for the accelerator from, say, your CPU. Qsharp is designed with a similar hybrid compute model in mind. Now, let's look at the Qsharp program. The syntax should look somewhat familiar, as we've designed it with ideas drawn from languages like C# and F#. For example, here you have code colorization. You can define and call operations, use let and if commands, and more. The teleport classical message operation takes as input a classical message represented by a Boolean value. The first thing to do is allocate a register to store quantum information. Here, I've allocated 2 qubits, initially assigned to the state 0 with the using command. I then assign each qubit a name, message, and there. I'm going to encode the message into the message qubit by applying an X operation, which is analogous to a not in classical logic. Here, if the message is 1, we apply the X operation to the qubit message, flipping its state. To teleport the message, let's look at this operation teleport. Teleport takes 2 qubits as input, message, and there. The first step is to allocate 1 more qubit, and we call it here. It's also initialized to state 0. Now, we use the H operation, or Hadamard gate, to place our qubit here into a superposition state. H takes the state 0 to 0 plus 1, and the state 1 to 0 minus 1. Recall that a qubit is a quantum bit of information, and it can be in a so-called superposition of values, not just 0 or 1, like a classical bit, but rather a combination of 0 and 1. This leads to a type of massive parallelism we can exploit in quantum algorithms and is a key quantum operation that you will use at the start of most every quantum algorithm you design. Now, after placing here into superposition, we apply a 2-qubit controlled not, or C-not, gate to the qubits here and there. C-naught flips the value of the there qubit if the here qubit is 1. Otherwise, it does nothing to either qubit. It's like an XOR gate in classical logic. Now, together, these two operations, H and C-naught, have enabled us to create entanglement between qubits here and there. Once entangled, the state of these 2 qubits is intrinsically correlated. If I do something to one of them, it instantaneously changes the state of the other one, even if I've spread them across the universe from each other. This entangled pair is a key resource for sending the message. I take the message qubit and load it into the entangled pair, using another C-naught on qubits message and here, followed by H on qubit message. Now I need to measure out the entanglement to conclude the teleportation of the message. I measure both the message and hear qubits using the M operation. At the end of a quantum algorithm, you will often perform a measurement to project the quantum information to a classical state, which you can then output and read. Here, we use the measurement output to conditionally apply quantum operations, Z, then X, to the there qubit. Now, returning to teleport classical message, we can measure the there qubit to see if it has the message. Let's check to see if the message was actually teleported into the there qubit and go back to the main calling program in the C# file. Now, the quantum development kit comes with a built-in universal quantum simulator. With it, you can run small instances of your quantum programs on your local hardware to around 30 simulated qubits. The qubit restriction is purely driven by your development machine. I'm using my everyday laptop for this simulation. In general, you'll need 16 gigs of RAM to simulate 30 qubits. Simulating one more qubit requires double the memory. Simulating one less halves the memory. Simulating 40 qubits requires roughly 1,000 times more memory than 30 qubits, coming in around 16 terabytes. So we also offer a simulator hosted in Azure that enables going beyond 40 qubits. To test our program, let's initialize and target the local simulator and call teleport classical message 8 times, each time with a random message of 0 or 1, or true or false. I'm going to print the result to the screen using the functionality of C#. Now, let's hit run. We can see that when the Boolean value is true, the there qubit also received true. So the message has been correctly sent. We've successfully teleported information and you've completed your first quantum algorithm. You can also debug your quantum program by setting a breakpoint and stepping through the code, which we'll cover in an upcoming Microsoft Mechanics episode. You can also use the built-in trace simulator provided with the preview release to estimate how many qubits and operations you are using in different parts of your quantum program. As you can see here in the Excel file, it outputs how many quantum gates are used within the different operations. With such information, you can optimize your algorithm to reduce the number of qubits and operations required. And we'll cover this in more detail in future episodes as well. Now, let's take a quick look at a more complex program. This example serves as a foundation for using quantum computing to solve problems in material science or chemistry. For example, to learn about new catalysts for improving the efficiency of a chemical reaction. Let's look at finding the ground state energy of a simple molecule, hydrogen. Now, here again, we call our quantum program from a classical one. This time written in F#. In this example, we're going to load classical data about estimations of the bond lengths. And then for each bond length, we use the quantum computer to estimate the ground state energy given that configuration. This example also uses many of the built-in library functions in Qsharp by calling microsoft.quantum.canon to enable easy programming of a very fundamental quantum algorithm. And you can see the many libraries available, arithmetic, phase estimation, and more. Now, in the F# code, I can exploit real-time plotting to see the output as it's calculated. When I hit run, you can see it plotting the ground state energy calculated on the quantum computer for 54 different bond lengths. The output from the quantum computer, as you can see, closely matches the results from theory developed over the last several decades. Now, molecular hydrogen is a very small molecule with just 2 hydrogen atoms. We can easily simulate it locally. To test larger molecules, we can use the Azure-based simulator when the algorithm requires more than 40 qubits. And ultimately, the quantum computer will allow us to go far beyond 40 qubits. We'll be able to study complex molecules that today require longer than the lifetime of the universe to study on our best supercomputers. And it will take just a matter of hours or days with a quantum computer. Our quantum development kit enables you to write programs for these large calculations today. So that was a quick introduction to the new Microsoft Quantum Development Kit in preview now. You can get started by accessing the preview at the link shown and get access to Qsharp, our simulators, code samples, and tutorials. Quantum computers will be revolutionary and enable us to start solving some of the world's most challenging problems in areas such as machine learning, global warming, and clean energy. To find out more about quantum computing and Microsoft's approach, join our quantum community. And thanks for watching. I look forward to seeing how you will harness quantum computing to kickstart the quantum computing revolution.